Bismillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi, wa man sara ala nahjihi, wa aqtafa atharahu ila yawmiddin. Allahumma rabbi shirah li sadri, wa yassir li amri, wa hlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Amma ba'du ibadallah, qala Allahu tabaraka wa ta'ala, a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Wa man yabtaqi ghayra al-islami deena, فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, I promise you to tell you some examples of the companions of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how they were obedient to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But inshaAllah tabaraka ta'ala, I won't talk about that this Jumu'ah in the future inshaAllah tabaraka wa ta'ala. What I saw the most important is to call upon those people who hate Islam. Either they are Jew, either they are Christian, either they are atheist. We call upon those people, why you hate Islam? Why you hate Islam? Some of them told that Islam facing troubles in the world, and he is the leader of those people. We will call upon that person, why you hate Islam? If you don't know about Islam, come and learn about Islam. If you don't know about the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, come and learn about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you don't know how Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dealt in Medina Munawwara, where the Islamic government started, and with the Christians, how he dealt with the Christians, with the Jew, even with the atheist, then come learn. Then you will reward bi-iznillahi tabarak wa ta'ala to Islam. You will accept that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a messenger of Allah and special slave of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, let's talk about few things which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran Kareem to us as a believer. How to deal with the non-believers of any kind, especially with the Ahli Kitab. We have a lot of ayah, special reminder, advice from Allah to us about Ahli Kitab, Jews and Christians, and the rest of the religion of people, either that they are Buddhist or either they are atheist or anything. What is the first reminder from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? لَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ لَمْ يُقَاتِلُكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَلَمْ يُخْرِجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ أَنْ تَبَرُّوهُمْ وَتُقْسِطُوا إِلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. First, Allah Ta'ala told us, O believers, O mu'mins, you have to be kind with the non-believers, non-Muslims, and you have to be just. Allah Ta'ala says, Allah Ta'ala will never stop you to be kind and just with those people whom are not fighting with you because of religion. They do not hate your religion. They do not hate Muslim. Subhanallah. وَلَمْ يُخْرِجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ. And they are not forcing you to go out from your country, go out from the your houses by force, which some of those non-believers, they are doing with our Muslim brothers and sisters in some parts of the world. Then Allah Ta'ala says, if these people are not doing these kind of things with you, antabarruhu, be nice with them. Be nice with them. وَتُقْسِطُوا إِلَيْهِمْ. And be just with them. Subhanallah. When you talk with them, talk with nicely with those people. When there is dispute, you have to be just with them. Any Muslim, the judge, Muslim judge, Muslim leader, public Muslims have to deal with them nice way. Why? إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. Because Allah Ta'ala loves those who are just. Allahu Akbar. This is the first advice from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Secondly, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala advised us, when you talk with Ahli Kitab, talk with them nice way, nice way. وَلَا تُجَادِلُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. When you speak, you have speak or conversation with the Ahli Kitab, speak with them in the nice and beautiful way. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says in other ayah, Allah Ta'ala ordered Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, وَجَادِلْهُمْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. Speak and do conversation. If there is debate between you and them about the deen, speak with them in the best way, subhanallah. This is the advice of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala to us as a nation of Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Opposite side, do others, they talk with us in a nice way, in some part of the world? No, they are not doing that. Also, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala ordered us, told us, you can eat the meat of animal which is slaughtered by active Christian, active Jew, religious Christian. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala mentioned there are a lot of rules and regulations. I don't want to talk about those. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala mentioned, Al-Yawma Uhilla Lakum Al-Tayyibat, Wa Ta'amu Al-Ladina Utul Kitab Hillul Lakum, Wa Ta'amukum Hillul Lahum. Allahu Akbar. What a great advice from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. When we are allowed to eat from the animal which they slaughter, he will be a butcher. In his slaughter, we do business with them, subhanallah. We are allowed to eat, but there are conditions. There are a lot of conditions, inshallah. Don't take it easy. If you would like to know about it more and more, you're most welcome to see me, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. This is another humble call from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to us to deal with these people nice way. Another advice from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to us or the Ahli Kitab, that we are allowed as a Muslim to marry Ahli Kitab, Jewish girls, subhanAllah, Jewish ladies, Christian ladies, as long they have a special condition, which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah. اليوم أحل لكم الطيبات وطعام الذين أوتوا الكتاب حل لكم وطعامهم حل طعامكم حل لهم والمحصنات من المؤمنات والمحصنات من الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم. محصنات from the Christian or Jew, you are allowed to get married. Subhanallah. And do remember, Allah Ta'ala mentioned about the husband and wife, وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مُوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. I made love, I create love and mercy between husband and wife. If a Muslim marry a Christian girl, there will be love in between them, subhanallah. No hatred. That is the advice of our Sharia. We will call you all those people whom you hate Islam. No, come learn Islam. You will love Islam, biiznillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. Also, in religious debates, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala ordered us to be very humble, nice. Speak with Ahli Kitab with the best way possible, the best way you can do. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَا نُشْرِكَ. Subhanallah. In this ayah, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talk with these people nice way. Oh, people of the book, come and sit with us, that we will won't worship except one Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and we won't make partners with Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Even Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala in the Quran Al-Kareem called upon the Ahli Kitab. Did he say, O Jew, O Christian, Ya Ahl Al-Kitab, Ya Ayuha Al-Ladina Utu Al-Kitab, O people of the book, O those whom been given a book, subhanallah. That is a kind of soft talk from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala with these Ahli Kitab, subhanallah. From this, Allah Ta'ala teaching us as well that we will deal with these people in nice and best way. Are they doing the same with us nowadays or not in some part of the world? Brothers and sisters, you will know, subhanAllah. Also, we learn from the Ahli Kitab, from Najran, which is in Saudi Arabia nowadays. They came to debate, to talk with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They believe Jesus was a son of Allah tabaraka ta'ala. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, Jesus, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, is a slave of Allah, and messenger of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. They came to Masjid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A lot of them, almost 60 people of them. And they had a nice conversation with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was talking with them with respect, subhanAllah, with respect. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. That is our religion. Never harm Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, any of them, while Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was alive. Also, brothers, how that was the advice of Allah to us. How we deal with these people, non-believers. Non-believers, subhanAllah. Now, we will come to the deal of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dealt with the Jewish Christians or the atheists, or even the those who are worshipping the statues, subhanAllah. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Al-Madina Munawwara, and established the Islamic government, the first constitution in the history of the human, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam set up that, subhanAllah. And there were 53 rules. Amongst those 53 rules were only for the Jew. How many? 27. 27 rules. I will just mention briefly four or five of them, inshaAllah, tabarak wa ta'ala, for your information. Why I would like to mention? Because we have to tell those people who hate Islam, who hate Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they make cartoons of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, come and listen. Come in here, come in, read how Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dealt with your ancestors. While Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had a power. He had an army like Khalid ibn Walid. He had an army, subhanAllah, like Umar radiallahu, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Abu Ubaidah, and Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and the rest of the Sahaba. They had a power there, and they had an Ansar there, Aus and Khazraj with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. He could do everything to those minority non-Muslims there, from the Jew and Christian in the atheist, subhanAllah. With that, he put a rules, constitution rules, for the safety of these people, subhanAllah. And that rules were for the Muslim. Oh, Muslims, these people are living in our country. In our country, they have to be safe from all sides of the life, subhanAllah. Few things I would like to mention with you. First thing is, they have a freedom of religion. We cannot force Christians or Jews to revert to Islam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, oh people, if you carry on with your religion, no problems, no problems. And we will carry on with our religion, which is Islam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never forced them, no, you have to leave your Christianity, you have to leave your Judaism, and you come to the Islam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave them a freedom of religion, subhanAllah. Also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave them the freedom of ownership of the land, house, gardens, whatsoever. They can buy, they can sell, subhanAllah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave them that freedom as well. And also Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told you people, minority, you will be protected. You will be protected. No one can harm you. No one can harm you. Either from the Muslim inside in the Medina, or either the other people coming and attacking upon the Medina, you people will be saved. You people will be saved. No one can harm you. Also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned to the Sahaba that we have to deal with these minority non-Muslims with just in love. Just in love. Also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was doing business with them. He was doing business with them, subhanAllah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, we know the story when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he put the cloth of the fight with a Jewish person and he took some food of him, subhanAllah. That is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And those people were minority, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could do everything to them. With that all, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dealt with them with love, in respect, and just. Not him only, he told to the Sahaba. That was constitution. That was the constitution of Islamic country. Islamic country, subhanAllah. That no one can harm these people, subhanAllah. Also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, من قتل معهداً معهداً لم يرح رائحة الجنة. A person who, any person kill a mu'ahad. Mu'ahad is a person which Islamic country give peace to that person, that you can live in our country. He is not Muslim. He is not Muslim. If he is not a non-believer of any kind and any religion, then Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, "Lam yarih ra'ihat al-jannah." If a Muslim he killed that, that Muslim will not smell that smell of the Jannah. Even a person can smell the Jannah from 40 years destination, subhanAllah. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam talking to whom? Not to the non-Muslims. To the Muslim, O Muslim, you are not allowed to kill non-Muslim, subhanAllah. Non-Muslim. Also, listen to the hadith of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ala man zalama mu'ahidan. Any person whom harm mu'ahad. Mu'ahad, as I told you, a person, he lives in Islamic country from any religion. أو انتقصه, or he bring him down. He humiliated him, subhanAllah. أو كلفه فوق طاقته, or he is working for him and he made him to work harder, tougher, because he is non-Muslim. If he, a person does that, فأنا حجيجه يوم القيامة. I will be reasoning with him in the day of judgment. Why you have done such a thing with the non-believer in such a time? SubhanAllah. Why you harm such a non-believer which is living in Islamic country? SubhanAllah. That is our religion, brother. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, I will stand in front of that Muslim who harmed the non-Muslim, subhanAllah. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam will be fighting for the non-Muslim hereafter, in the day of judgment, subhanAllah. But what are these other people are doing who harming Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? They're making cartoons of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Oh person, we calling upon you, just go and learn about the dealt of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with your ancestors. How he dealt with your ancestors, learn from them properly. Then if you make cartoons of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam afterwards, then that will be up to you, subhanAllah. Also, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he went in for the visit of the sick person of the Jewish. One person, young boy, he was servant of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He was Jew and he became sick. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he went to visit him. Then he told him, oh such a boy, revert to Islam. Say, Shahadu an la ilaha illallah wa shahadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. I will witness for you in day of judgment in front of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Then he looked after toward his father. Then father told him, Ati' abal Qasim. Obey the father of Qasim, which is Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he reverted to Islam. See, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went to visit a young boy, sick young boy, you know, to visit, and that was Jew, subhanAllah. That is our leader, Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accepted gifts from the Christians, from the Jew as well. One lady, she cooked a sheep for Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and brought it to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she put poison in that sheep that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will eat and die, subhanAllah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accepted from her. And even wahi revelation come to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Jibreel told that there is poison, don't eat. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left that lady, go out free, you know, never harm that lady, subhanAllah. Now, one Muslim does something, entire Muslim in Islam will be blamed by the non-Muslim. One Muslim does something, subhanAllah. Even that Muslim cannot represent Islam, cannot represent an entire Muslim, subhanAllah. The leaders of the non-Muslim, they stand and they talk about against Islam, talk bad about Islam. What a not a good character or manner from those people, subhanAllah. Also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he respected the janazah, that of the Jew. One day, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with his companions, Then the janazah of the Jew was passing by. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stood up. Then the Sahaba told him, Ya Rasulullah, he is Jewish. He is Jewish. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told, Inna al-mawta faza, fa'idha ra'aytum al-janazah faqumu. A death is a fear. If you see the janazah, then stand up for it. Stand up for it. Then another narration, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, told to his companions, Alaysat nafsa, isn't this Jew which passed away, he had a soul, he was a human? For respect of the human, we will stand up. Allahu Akbar. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stood for the Jewish. He passed away as a respect to that person, subhanallah. But nowadays, non-Muslim, they disrespect that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and disrespect the Muslims as well in the same time. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Also, Jewish and Christian, they were going to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In doors of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were open to everyone. They were going and sitting with whom? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and asking Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the worldly thing, about the religion as well, subhanallah. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, humble way, he was replying and answering their questions as well. Also, even Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he hired people, which is non-Muslim, to help Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To help Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Medina Munawwara, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told to the Jewish people, O Jewish people, if someone attack with us, then we will be together, combined together to defend, subhanallah. You come, we will be with you together, and we will defend our enemy of our country, which is Medina al-Munawwara, subhanallah. Even in migration, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was migrating to Medina al-Munawwara, he hired a person, which his name is Abdullah ibn Uraytid. And he was non-Muslim, subhanallah. He was non-Muslim to guide him to reach to Medina al-Munawwara. To reach to Medina al-Munawwara. See, that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in how he was dealing with the non-Muslim. Of course, brothers, in that critical time, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is talking with a person which is a non-believer, and to take him to Medina and save him from the mushrikeen. Allahu Akbar. In that time, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used a non-believer as well. See our beauty of religion, of Islam, brothers and sisters. See the manners and characters of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala clarified the manners of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you have a best character, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned about Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. I did not send you but as a mercy to the mankind. We will tell to those non-believers of today, that if you talk about Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about Islam, do you remember Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he brought mercy for you, but you don't know the value of that mercy. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make us from those who learn Quran and Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and act upon it and pass it to others. And may Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make us practical Muslims. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make us from those whom has love with Quran, to read, to learn, to pass the message of Quran to others. May Allah ta'ala make us from those who has love to the Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to learn and to act and to pass it to others. And may Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala give us all joyful life in this dunya and hereafter. And may Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala protect us all from the harm of those who are harming us. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gather us all in Jannat al-Firdaus. And may Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make our children pious, active, hafazat al-Quran al-Kareem. And may Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala be pleased with those brothers and sisters whomever helping Masjid as-Salam. وَمَا عَلَيَّ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ.